Lisa Curry, she's one of Australia's swimming golden girls, a triple Olympian. She quickly became a darling of the media and seemingly has always led a charmed life. But punctuating her hard-earned success and great joy has been an enormous amount of heartache and grief, which she details in a new memoir. And Lisa Curry joins us now from her home on the Sunshine Coast. Lisa Curry, so good to see you.
Yeah.
Good morning, Sarah and Tristan. How are you?
Oh, we're great.
We're really good. You get an applause in the audience today from the studio crew. We're pumped to speak to you, lovely. What a life you
have. Oh, I heard that. I thought it was just a crackle.
No. The applause is for you. Gee, you've lived an incredible life. I've been listening to your audiobook, which is read by you, and what's really lovely is that it sort of sounds like you're sitting down chatting with a friend, spending time with a friend, and you get to laugh and cry with you. So what's the process been like of writing your story?
Oh, it was really hard. I wanted to write a book when I was 50, and it just never eventuated. And then, of course, turning 60, it's another perfect time to write a book. But then, of course, you know, things happened in the last couple of years, and there was no way that I was ever going to write a book. And it was, we've only just got there. The publishers really pushed me to get it done, and it was really hard because there were days when I, you know, I couldn't even get out of bed, let alone write some words or even say anything. But the audiobook was really interesting because you can read your book, but reading your book out loud is completely different. Mm-hmm. And have you listened to the whole book?
I've been putting it on to go to sleep with Lisa Curry. You've been, your dulcet tones have been gently gently serenading me to sleep. Oh, it's lovely. I'm about halfway through it, but it's an incredible book.
Oh, okay.
And there's so much that
it was really.
You go.
Yeah, sorry, I was just going to say, like, don't be driving when you hear the end of it, because it was so hard. I just was going from comma to comma, but I don't want people to be driving a car when that's on. And, I'm glad you've enjoyed it, because I haven't listened to it back. I hate listening to my own voice, so.
Oh, it's lovely.
I'm glad you like it.
It's really, it's really lovely. And you've had quite a couple of years, Lisa. You lost your beautiful daughter, Jamie, less than 2 years ago. It's still very raw for you, obviously. Are you doing okay?
Some days I am. Some days are just really shit, basically, you know. And it was interesting just listening to the couple of people before you, you know, about gut health and about body image and all of those things really, you know, affected Jamie terribly, you know, when in her teens, and that's kind of where it started. And there's so much emphasis on weight and weight loss programs and eat this and eat that. And, you know, it's kind of what my company does now as well. We have a range of beautiful eating programs and everything's natural, everything's nutritious. And, you know, it's just, people are trying to find, you know, the quick fix, and but it's affecting so many young people, and it just changes their chemistry at a really early age. In fact, it was my business partner, Jeff Butterworth, who diagnosed Jamie with a chemical imbalance when she was 15. So that's how long we were dealing with it. But, you know, you can have three children, or as Tristan would say, three children, in the nicest Irish accent, because my dad was Irish, so I love the Irish accent. It's funny because when Dad used to be drinking, I couldn't understand a word he said. Dad, can you speak in English? I can't understand a word you're saying.
It's the same here, Lisa.
You know, but you have three children, and you bring them up all the same, and yet one just gets loaded with all this, you know, all these issues. It's been really hard. It's been horrible.
It is.
But, you know, the good thing is that my story is now in black and white. Mm-hmm. I don't have to rely on my menopausal brain to remember anything. and, you know, when I went to Ireland to do Who Do You Think You Are and learn all about my dad's background and my mum's background, and I didn't know their backgrounds, but at least my kids now and my grandchildren will be able to read all about Granny and not have to wonder.
Well, that's the great thing. And myself and Sarah was just talking about this morning, because we've had different experience of your book in the sense that it's been an audio book and I've been reading it.
Yeah.
And as I've been reading it, I messaged you last night and I was like, I love this, because you're talking about your family growing up and the things that you experienced. And I was so buzzing. It was so relatable. And then I got to a chapter, what was dark, undercurrents, and it completely threw me. And I know you talked about your father and how difficult it was to kind of speak about your father in those terms. And it really just threw me. The reason I say that is because when I met you first, it was obviously through Dancing with the Stars when Jet competed on it. And I hadn't known too much about you. I mean, I knew your name, I knew what you did. But the thing that instantly struck me was that how tight your family was. Mm. Everybody was there together. Yourself, Grant, Mark, Jet. You were talking so much. You always supported each other so well. And I was still trying to get my head around the dynamics. But I think that's such a great thing, because the way you guys work together and you co-parent is so amazing to me.
Yeah, and we kind of made a really conscious decision early on, because my dad wasn't around much when I was swimming. He missed my greatest successes. You know, he missed seeing, you know, the really big moments in my life. And Grant and I decided we would be there every time for our kids, the little athletics, the ballet, the gymnastics, the diving, the nippers, swimming, everything. We were always there for our kids. Mm-hmm. And we are such a close bond. And, you know, Grant and I were together the other night just having a chat about different things. And he really wants to read the book, which is interesting. He might read a few things he doesn't really want to know. But anyway, that's the surprise of the book, isn't it? But, yeah, look, we are a close family, and Grant and Mark get on really well, and, you know, everything's sweet, so...
Everything kind of relates. Yeah.
You know, just missing my bookends now, so, it's, you know, apart from that, you know, life is...
Everything seems to relate to everything that we're talking about as well. We're talking about kind of dieting and food as well. That was a huge part of your life, and it didn't seem to affect you in the same kind of way, certainly preparing for the Olympics, working so hard towards the Olympics, then your first one was in communist Russia. It would have been a completely different experience for you as well.
Yeah, look, you know, I've never had an issue with my weight at all. I didn't really like talking about it, but I knew how to coach people to get the best out of themselves in a healthy way. So, you know, that's what I've been doing for the, you know, past 30 years, and still doing it now with my company, Happy Healthy You. But doing it in a way where people feel good about themselves and finding their happy weight, where they can, you know, eat what they like and eat nutritiously, exercise moderately, to feel good about yourself, because it's not about being like the people you see on TV, because it's, you know, they're a very small minority in the world, you know. So every day we have to wake up and enjoy our lives, because as we know now, you never know when it's going to be your last. So let's just get on with life and live. Actually live, not just exist.
Yeah, that's right. How's the love of your life going, Mark?
He's gorgeous.
Is he there?
He's just over there.
Oh, beautiful man.
Oh, he's over there. Yeah, I know. He's thank goodness COVID's finished, because he had no work for 2 years, and he's just coming back now doing all his great shows. And he's got a really big show in Sydney on May the 21st at the State Theatre, and another big one in Melbourne at Hamer Hall. And, you know, it's just packed out crowds wherever he goes. He's so good at what he does. And we had a memorial here at our place for my mum, and Grant came along, and it was the first time he'd heard Mark sing. Mark sang "I Did It My Way" for Mum. Aww. And he came over and he said, "Gee, Mark can really sing, can't he?" I said, "Well, yeah, that's what he does, you know."
He must be in the pool.
He can sing. Yeah, I know. I mean, he can sing, my kids can dance, but I didn't get any of that, so, oh well.
Well, actually, we want to ask you about that.
Yeah, how's the jazz ballet? Yeah. I remember reading in the book when it's a no-go, huh? How's Jet doing, by the way?
I actually remember that, yeah. Yeah, they're doing great. You know, from that one little time, which you'll read about in the book, about my dancing ability, you can see that I passed it on to Jet and Morgan. And Jamie was a good dancer as well. But Morgan's still dancing. She's 8.5 months pregnant. She's about to drop this baby any day. And she's still doing Latin dancing. Jet was great on Dancing with the Stars. Thank you for being so kind to him, Tristan. And Sarah, I know you were in Paris and interviewed Morgan when she was there. So
that was 10 years ago, Lisa. Can you believe that?
I know. She would go back tomorrow. She just loves being on stage dancing.
Oh, she was brilliant at it. Hey, you turn 60, what, in a couple of weeks? 10 days?
15, I turn 60 on Sunday week. Ooh. Sunday week. And Mark's got something planned for me. He always has surprises. I don't know what it is. But I said to him, I think I've decided that I'm not going to have a 60th birthday. I'm going to have a 60th birth year.
Yes.
There we go. I am going to do whatever I want for the whole year. We've booked 2 holidays already, things that have been on our bucket list. So I'm just, you know, I spent 30 years of my life swimming, 30 years of my life with family and business. And I think I might spend the next 30 years just bloody enjoying life, I think.
Good on
you. And that would make everyone happy, Lisa, because you've been nurturing other people for so long. Maybe turn it in a little bit. We can't wait to see what you do next. Maybe even if it's just a little bit of a rest first.
That's it. You deserve it.
Lisa's new memoir is out now. It's a gorgeous read. If you can get the audiobook as well, it's definitely worth it. Lisa Curry, thank you for your time and thank you for your beautiful story.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Loved you
both. Thank you. Bye. Love to everyone. All the best.